Well, it's been an agonising 3 years today since 18-year-old Belgian backpacker Theo Hayez disappeared in Byron Bay.
Theo was last seen leaving the Cheeky Monkeys nightclub at 11 p.m. on May 31st, 2019. And despite New South Wales Police offering a $50,000 reward for information, the mystery of Theo's disappearance remains unsolved.
Theo's godfather, Jean-Philippe Pector, joins us now from Melbourne. Jean-Philippe, thank you for joining us this morning. Private investigator Ken Gamble has spoken about some credible new leads. What are your thoughts on these?
So we are receiving continuously through the website and the channels that we put in place new information, sometimes that are not at all credible, but some are more credible than others. And so Ken is helping us to check and to try to follow those leads. It's unfortunately, until now, none of them are fine enough to provide us with any answers. But having Ken on our side is a really comforting thought, because, like I said, it's this. We know nothing, and so there's so much to look to, and so yeah, that's an incredible help that he provided us.
Jean-Philippe, as a parent, I mean, my worst nightmare is my kids walking out the door and you're not seeing them again. Mm. How are Theo's parents coping with all of this?
Look, it's really tough, and unfortunately, time doesn't help. It doesn't get easier with time when you've got a loss of that sort with no explanation at all of what could have happened. So they coping and surviving, I would say, mostly with a incredible strength, probably thanks to the love and support that people and myself are giving to them, so that they can have some kind of hope that at some point we will have some answers.
Jean-Philippe, it is just so baffling. Google tracking data shows that Theo took a jagged path down to Tallow Beach and then ventured into quite thickly vegetated bush. You're Theo's godfather. Is that in character for him to wander down to this part of the beach alone? What do you think happened?
No, it's not at all in touch with his character. Like, he is a responsible person, someone really careful, and he would never take risks and without calculation. So from the start, we have put forward that is really, really odd. He would not go alone in a dark night into the bushland and take risk of even climbing cliffs and stuff like that. So it's really odd. It doesn't make sense. He must have been with somebody to be able or to want to do that.
Mm. Theo, can you... Jean-Philippe, can you set the scene a little bit of what happened with Theo and his cousin Liz? Because they travelled to Melbourne after finishing school. How did they end up in Byron?
So, Lisa and Theo did two separate travel. They were both in working holiday visa in Australia, but they did indeed meet at some point along their travel. Melbourne was at the start of Theo's journey in Australia, and they met again a bit further down after Theo traveled up to Cairns and down to the East Coast. He met Lisa again at Lisa's brother's place in Brisbane, and from there, I guess Theo was going to travel back towards Sydney and then Melbourne to join me again before going back to Belgium. Byron Bay was on the road, on the list of things to do, and so he decided that because he had still a little bit of time, that it would be good if he had a stop there. It was not with Lisa, but it was after seeing her. So I think Byron Bay is really attractive for yeah, for the postcard point of view. Yeah. Once you know Byron Bay with from our point of view, after what happened, unfortunately, Byron Bay lost a bit of the bright colours.
The Missing Persons Advocacy Network has been giving you support. It has been 3 years. What would you like to say for anyone watching today who might have seen Theo, who might have some information? What do you want to say to them?
Oh, look, I would like to first to thank MPAN and Lorraine O'Keefe, who have provided us an incredible help and support through the whole ordeal and with really compassionate and sensible advices. It's something that no one would hope to experience. It's something totally new. So going through that kind of experience is really tough. So it's, yeah, MPAN has been there from the beginning and is still there with us, providing us support, which is really good, as well as the local volunteer in Byron Bay, what we call our Byron family. So the core volunteers that still support us continuously for 3 years. It's been incredible. We really hope that with the reward that has been offered, somebody will come and with information, with valid information that will help to solve the mystery.
Jean-Philippe, please give our love and our thoughts to the family. Thank you so much for joining us today on the show. 3 years, three of the toughest years I can imagine of your life.
Thank you for the interest. Thank you.
Just so hard, right? 18, world at his feet, finished school, on an adventure.
If there's anybody out there, anybody who may know anything, it could be the smallest detail. If you happen to be in Byron 3 years ago today, please contact the family or police, because anything that they can find out will help out.
Yeah.